Okay, let's cut the intro and unpacking and get straight to the point. This is a first impression video, not like real review, so this phone obviously has a lot of features, but if you need a detailed info on this phone, please let me know in comments, so maybe later I will make a full in-depth review. It looks very big at the first glance, but when you pick it up, it actually fits in your palm very well. I have, let's say, average size palms, and I don't feel the difference between, for example, my previous phone, which was Nexus 5X. So I would say it's a good for both men and women. This phone's difference is more like in its length. The aspect ratio is not really standard, 18 by 9, so it's vertically longer than other phones. I've been using this phone only for just 2 days, but what I understood is that this extra length is for lower and upper features. Videos, for example, will be still playing 16 by 9, but leaving you extra black space on top and bottom. I guess it leaves you more space for navigating your phone. As camera is almost the most important feature in phones nowadays, this budget phone does the work well. Indoors, outdoors, and night images are very nice. Of course, less details than, for example, in Google Pixel 2. But still, I mean, Google Pixel 2 costs more than 600 euros. But this one is a budget phone. So this phone has two cameras, 12 and 20 megapixels. But one is designed to shoot better in dark. So there is one parameter you switch on and night images will be even better looking. And then there is 20 megapixels front camera. It has very funny features. It's all about beauty mode for front camera, which you can switch on and off, of course. And there are also advanced beauty options like big eyes, smooth face, skin tone. Does it mean it's a perfect women phone? Or a perfect Chinese phone? I don't know. Anyways, it's fun to play around the cameras on this phone. It also has manual shooting mode, slow-mo, some filters and more. I would describe this phone with the word 80% smooth. Probably one of the best things about this phone is that it comes with minimal bloatware and basically is a clean Android. I use only Google features and apps, and I'm very happy about the fact that I can continue to do it on this phone too. Battery lasts for surprisingly long time. I have been downloading all the apps, synchronizing my data, testing phone and all the features, and I left it during the night with 14% battery, hoping that it's gonna die. But no, I woke up with 10% battery. It's quite amazing. And it took me about an hour to fully charge it. I don't really know if it's fast charging. I think it's okay. Call quality. The sound is clear, indoors and outdoors. I can hear the person very clearly. And the same is on the other side. That person says he can hear me very clearly. Comparing to other phones, this phone's maximum brightness is quite low. When on other phones I set it to medium, on this phone I need to set it almost maximum. It's still very clear and all, but just I want to let you know that it's not that bright. A nice feature is that the rubber case comes with the phone, so you don't have to worry about that weird camera sticking out of the phone. And if you don't like it, just buy a new one. Another nice feature is that charger comes with USB to USB-C, which is usually very rare, as other chargers nowadays come USB-C to USB-C, so it's kind of problematic to find a random charging spot. I've never had a phone with such feature. At first I thought, why would I need it? but after connecting it to my TV, it actually made sense. You get the second remote and can control things from your phone. I guess it's very useful for people who have indoor light system, air conditioning, audio system, and now they can control them through the phone, not just using Bluetooth, but now can use infrared port. User guidebook consists of very limited info. Very weird for me. I guess if it's your first smartphone, you will need to do a lot of research online. No problem for me, of course, as it's an Android and works as any other phone I had. It's not a water-resistant phone. However, it also doesn't have a headphones jack. So maybe they wanted to design a water-resistant phone and then gave up? I don't know. You can put two SIM cards in this phone. However, if you have one like me, you cannot put SD card in the other slot. I'm a bit disappointed by that because I would like to have some extra memory. There is a stabilization mode when you're filming, but I think there is not when you're taking pictures. So if you have shaky hands, with this camera, some images will probably be blurry. Good price, good camera, nice design and free from bloatware. Overall, I'm very pleased with it. As this is a new phone, I didn't have enough time to test my camera properly. So I'm planning to put some new images in the description later on. So stay tuned, come back to this video later.